What's up YouTube? Today I want to show you how to do some advanced photo editing inside Stable Diffusion and how you can throw images back and forth between a photo editing tool called PhotoPea, and then you can send it to text to image, back to image to image, back to PhotoPea, and so on. This is amazing for your Stable Diffusion game because you can now do some advanced editing. I'm going to show you the magic of layering and non-destructive editing and some of the many possibilities that you can do with this tool, just a few of them because this tool has a lot of tricks. We're also going to do some texture transfer, so you can transfer a texture or something, one particular thing about a photo back and forth between two photos and blend it in and make it look like it was there all along. This tutorial is definitely going to up your game. So if you take a look at my thumbnail here, you'll see that there's a lot of colorful text that I kind of absorbed some of the textures from another picture. And there's this galaxy in the background, and that was pulled into the original picture, as well as these orbs that were cloned from an original orb, and I just made a bunch of them. So here's the original photo, and to tell you the truth, I prefer this photo over the thumbnail, but the thumbnail shows you a lot of the elements that I'm going to show you in the tutorial. Now let's take a look at how I did this, but first let's install PhotoPea. I did a full video on it and I'll leave that in my video description, but let me just give you a 30-second install tutorial. But if you already have PhotoPea installed, just go ahead and skip to the next section. Just a shout out to somebody who helped me correct the name on this tool. So I was calling it like PhotoPea or PhotoPea. It's actually PhotoPea, which is like kind of like PhotoPea. Makes sense. Thank you for that. So PhotoPea. I'm probably going to mispronounce it several time still. First, we got to grab the link for PhotoPea. Go to my video description and then you'll have a link for PhotoPea right here. Click on it and actually open the site, then go to the green code button, click on it, and then click the double squares to get the link. Now we got to head over to Stable Diffusion and then click on the extensions tab. Now click on the install from URL sub tab and then paste the link right there into the URL for extensions.git repository. You can do that by making sure you're clicked in that box over there and then press Control V, then click on the big orange install button. Now you got to go to the installed sub tab and then check for updates and then click on the apply and restart, and now you're actually done. You should now have a PhotoPea tab next to all the rest of your Stable Diffusion extension tabs. This takes less than a minute to do, and now you have a legit photo editor inside your Stable Diffusion. Alrighty, now that you have PhotoPea installed, let's go ahead and play with it. First, we need an image, right? I'm going to recreate my thumbnail, so I'm going to just go ahead and jump into an extension called Image Browser, which is a pretty amazing extension if you don't know about it. And I'll make a top 10 extensions and feature it, but it shows you all the pictures that you created, and it's very similar to Midjourney's kind of personal library. It shows you all the images you created and it shows all the information about your image. But in Stable Diffusion, it's even more useful because it's going to show you the seed, it's going to show you exactly what you put in to create that, and it's going to show you the thousands of settings that you have to set, the denoising strength, exactly everything, so you can recreate your picture with all the settings over here. All right, so let me look through here. All right, here's the picture I want to work on, and I'm going to try and recreate the thumbnail of this video using this picture, which is the one that I used. So for my first trick, I'm going to be transferring my textures between two images using layering. There's so much you can do with this trick. I mean, so much. This is where the magic happens. But for now, I just want to get some clean eyes and lips. But you can also use this to add freckles, pore details, fix a character's teeth, or you can even turn a character into a scaly monster. You can mesh things into their skin. It's a pretty powerful tool, and you can do it where it just blends in perfectly. So just learn this, and the world is your oyster. I mean, sure, you can do face restore with GFPGAN for what I'm trying to do right now, but most people don't do this because it removes a lot of the art style and the texture. So we just want certain things fixed and we want to choose how much cleanness to bring in. So we don't want to just like smooth face, right? All right, so I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom right and then just click right here where it says send to extras. Then I'm going to do an upscale of 1.5 because it's already at 1400-ish. And I don't want to make this photo too big, so I don't want PhotoPea to lag, but I don't want it pixelated when I'm working on it so I can kind of get better results. Cool, so now I upscale my image and now I'm going to go ahead and click on send to PhotoPea. All right, so now we got to go back to the extras tab again because we need the clean face, the restored face. We need that for the second layer. So I'm turning on GFPGAN for this upscale and I'm going to put it all the way up to 0.8 with a 0.3 code former visibility and a 0.4 code former weight. The weird thing about code former is the lower the number is, the higher the weight is. That's it's kind of backwards, right? But you know, that's none of my business. Yoink. So the eyes are fixed, but Well, hold on, wait a minute. What is this? So it's not completely perfect, like it usually comes out perfect, but you know, that's actually pretty good because I can actually show you another thing. So we're gonna keep this and we're gonna do it live.
We'll do it live.
Okay.
Do it live! Thing sucked!
Let's send it into PhotoPea and we'll take this fail and turn it into a positive. Turn the tables here. So click on send to PhotoPea and let's do some editing. The first thing to take note of is the layers. So there's a little layer button here at the top right. It's looks like three little slabs of something, paper or slabs. But make sure you click on the icon if you don't see, if your window doesn't look like mine. Now we're gonna click on one of the eye icons to hide one of the layers. Just choose one of the layers. Preferably the top one, I guess. So I'm gonna click hide for the top one by unclicking the eye. And then all I'm looking at is the face restored one, which means this bottom one, since it still has the eye turned on, is the actual GFPGAN one. So I'm gonna go ahead and rename this one to GFPGAN by clicking on the current name and then just kind of typing in GFPGAN. And you wanna do this because you don't wanna confuse the two images. It can get very confusing really fast. You could be working between 5 to 6 layers, and if you don't know which layer is which, you're going to be in trouble. All right, cool. Now we know which layer is which, and we're going to keep the top one unchecked for now. So we're going to keep that one hidden. So go ahead and click on the image in the bottom layer, which is a GFPGAN one, and then the image itself, not the actual text like we did earlier. And you should now see a white square around it, which means that you're working on this picture now, and that's the one that you see on the screen. Now this picture looks nice. GFPGAN did a great job, but you can see here one of the eyes is not perfect. Then you could also see a tile around her face if you look really closely, and that's where the face restore happened, and it just does that sometimes on certain images, if not all of them. Most people won't see this, but it's there. Like, you can actually kind of change the lighting to see it, but it's definitely there. So let's head on over to the clone tool, which looks like a rubber stamp here on the left. Now just click on it, and then you want to make sure your blend mode is set to normal and that your opacity is at 100%. Now I'm going to go ahead and press on Alt and Control to scroll and zoom up into the picture so I can see way into her face so I can work just on her eyes. Now the weird thing is sometimes it's Alt, sometimes it's Control, but try one of them and then scroll up and down. It keeps changing on me. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong. All right, so now we're gonna have to adjust the size of our clone tool. So at the top left here, just go ahead and choose the solid brush. Alrighty. Now I'm gonna go ahead and just choose the right size. Really wish there was a shortcut for this. If anybody knows, like a mouse shortcut, let me know. So now I'm gonna clone the good eye. So just go ahead and hover over the good eye right in the center, then hold Alt or press K and then left click. All right, so you've now copied that area. Now when you start left clicking, you're gonna start drawing something. So you're gonna just start drawing this eye. So look, I'm gonna draw on her forehead. So you could kind of see what it's doing. It's kind of drawing from that center point, but we don't want it on her forehead. So press Control Z. And so I'm going to go over to the bad eye and I'm going to go right in the center. So I'm just going to kind of left click right in the middle of that eye and rub it in. Just rub it in good. And just, you know, don't worry. You can always press Control Z. All right. So I got something I like. And if you messed up a little bit, you can always go ahead and clone like a smaller portion and then just try to color it in that way. So if you really want to blend it in, you could actually use the heal tool instead. So you can right click on this band-aid looking icon and then choose a second option here, which is the brush. And then just hold Alt and click somewhere near the object that you want to kind of copy. This is also known as the pimple eraser tool because it'll do a pretty good job at that. All right, so now I'm going to unhide and select the top layer since I'm done fixing the eye. And I'm going to call the eyes good and bring it over with a layer mask. All right, so when you're working with layering, you have the ability to create a vector mask and do a non-destructive edit. And this is where all the magic happens in Adobe and other photo editors. When you create a mask on top of a layer and work within that layer, then I'll start bringing in textures and colors from the image below it. So it'll start to bleed into the photo. If you set the brush to be a really low kind of intensity, it'll start to blend in with your picture. And this is more useful than you think. And there's so many tricks that you can do just based off this one thing. So let's try this out, shall we? First, we're actually gonna make sure that the GFPGAN image is on the bottom and that both icons are checked so we can see both images. Now, if you had to align two images or if you wanted to just kind of see the bottom image, you can actually select the top image opacity up here and then just lower it to like 30%, and then you could kind of move it around. You can also do this if you want to actually take something else, like you want a double eyebrow or something like that, something crazy like that. Now let's click on the top image and you'll see a white box around it in the layering box. Now you want to go down a little bit and click on the vector mask. So down here, it looks like the Japanese flag or basically a square with a circle in the middle. Now, once you click on that, a gray or white box will actually pop up besides your top image here. And that's the vector mask. So now make make sure that you're inside that mask by clicking on it. This next step's very important. The reason I say that is because we're going to paint black onto the mask so we uncover holes in the top layer for the bottom layer to come through or shine or bleed in or whatever you want to call it. And when you paint on a white mask, you're actually covering those holes back up and showing only the top layer. So if you're on the image itself rather than the mask, you're actually vandalizing your model by painting black or white on her face. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and take the textures from the good eye, the good lips from the GFPGAN image and pull it through to the top image. So select black as your foreground by going here to the bottom left of your screen and making sure that the black color is in the front, which is your foreground. If it's not, just go ahead and press on that L-shaped double arrow, which will switch it between foreground and background colors. You can actually click on the square itself to change the color of it. Pro tip, if you actually choose like a grayish color, you'll get like an in-between result or a blended effect. Now let's take a closer look at our eye by holding Control and or Alt and zooming in. Like I said, it's either or. It's just kind of luck of the draw, I guess. Now click on your brush tool, which is over here on the left, or you can press B, and that's the shortcut for it. But at the top of the toolbar, you want to change the size of your brush, and there's also some different tips here. So select the softer tip, which is this one right here. And I'm going to go with a size that matches her eye, or the area around her eye, because I'm pulling in more than just her eye. Now I'm going to lower the opacity to around 50 and the flow to 40, which is right here. And it's going to make the brush even softer, which is something you want to do because normally you want to blend things in. You don't want to just a hard kind of two-tone, like one image then the other image. You want it to like kind of look like it was there all along, that it blends and that it belongs there. Heads up, on the right side, you'll also see a lot of options for tools like your brush, for layering, for channels, for paths, all those types of things. Now let's just start painting black over her eye. And remember, we're inside the vector mask, not the image itself. So if you see black going over her eye, instead of the actual image getting fixed, then go ahead and fix that. So start painting the black over her eye, and then now you can see that the GFPGAN eyes are coming through. I mean, look how freaking awesome that is. Now compare the two eyes. I mean, look at this. It's like night or day. You can also do this the other way around by putting the GFPGAN photo on the top with a light brush and maybe opacity around 30 and flow 30. And start pinning over the face to bring in as many textures, pimples, freckles, or whatever you liked about the original art style and you want to bring it back to the face that got taken away by the face restore. You also want to do this with a really light brush. You want it to blend and you don't want too much of the original skin to show up. You don't want it spotty, so just make sure you keep that in mind. And the cool thing about this is non-destructive edit, so you can actually mess up and then you just swap the colors, switch it back to white, and then you could start blending backwards. You can start changing what you did gradually and unblending and blending, and it's a pretty useful technique, and it's going to be one that you're going to use a lot. Now when you're done, just go ahead and right click on the vector mask and click apply. Let's do one more thing with the eyes before we move on. So I'm going to zoom all the way in, like right into her eye, and then I'm going to use the lasso tool, which kind of looks like a lasso or a rope or a necklace. Now I'm just going to select around her eye as best as I can. So I'm holding the left click here and I'm drawing around her eye. Now go up to layers over here as one of the tool options and then go to select new fill layer. Then select a color to fill in, something like red, green, or blue. I'm going to choose red. Now I'm going to go into the layers panel and then click on the blend modes here and set it to hue. Now I'm going to click on the color box and then change the color to the desired color you want. So right here, I'll choose this color. Yep, that looks nice. And so you can do this to both eyes. You can have like different colored eyes. You can have different color lips. You can change the color of anything. You could reduce the intensity. It's pretty powerful. All right, so let's export this image, which is basically saving the image. Make sure that what you're looking at on the canvas is what you want to save, and then click on File, and then click on Export As, and then click on PNG, and then click Save. And it should go to the default location. If you're not sure, just go to Downloads, then click on the little folder button just to check where it went. Or you can send it back to image to play with it some more, and then when you do that, it's going to save it into your folders. Okay, so I wanted to cram a lot more into this video. I want to show you how to blend it in the background and how to blend in an item that you clone that looks too fake or something, and how to put it like behind clouds, as well as how to put textures on text so it looks like it's part of the image. This video is already way too long. It's 15 minutes, so I'm going to stop right here and put that into part 2 for this tutorial. And if you like the video, just go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It helps me out big time. And if you like AI art, go ahead and check out this video here or that video there. And thanks a lot for watching. Take it easy.